point estimation and the confidence intervals. So these are all the two stuff we have seen in the previous session. Now, what is the new point we are going to discuss about is, say, point estimation. That example is mean. Very clear. So our standard deviation. Interval estimation, this is based on confidence interval. That is the meaning, confidence interval. Okay. Now I will make you to understand confidence interval with through simplest demonstration. Then we go to statistical. For example, I'm asking you, what is the confidence you are having exactly to get 73 in the statistics paper? Exactly 73, I'm asking. Not more than 73 also, I don't want. Not less than 73 also, I don't want. You may be capable enough, you want to get 100. You may be not capable, you may fail also, you may get 50 also. That is fine. But I'm not bothered that. Exactly 73. The moment I ask like this, what will happen? You will not have any confidence at all. So confidence level would go to zero. Next, I'm giving a range, interval. What is the confidence level of 50 to 60? Narrow confidence. This is called narrow confidence. Very 10 only I'm giving. When the confidence level is very narrow, what would be, yeah, at least you will have some amount of confidence. If not 30%, you may have 50%. Some amount of confidence has been increased. Please mute your Jennifer. Yeah. It is increased. Hope so you can agree. Your confidence level is increased. Now I am asking you a question. Every individual, you can imagine, what is the confidence interval of getting the mark between 30 to 70, I'm asking. Got my point? How many of you know confidence interval earlier? If you know only, you need to answer quickly in 1 minute. Less than 1 minute. I want to see the chat window or unmute, you can talk. If you know confidence interval, you need to say, yes, I know confidence interval. Something like that. Okay. Half of the minute over, I understood. Okay, this is the first time you are learning this terminology called confidence interval. I assume like that. Through this example, you can exactly understand. Now, try to interpret. Now, I am giving the interval, larger interval from the narrow interval. Now, 30 to 70 marks. Every one of you, what is the confidence interval of getting 30 to 70 marks is the question I am raising. Now look at the scenario. Your confidence interval is increased. Your confidence is increased. When the interval is increased, your confidence is also will be increased. Look at here, the interval is increased. 30 to 70. A quite good confidence interval I had given. Means interval I had given. So that your confidence is increased up to 60%. Next. Further, I am increasing that interval, wider interval. What is the confidence you are having that you will get a mark 20 to 80 in statistics? Naturally, your confidence would be more because I'm giving wide range, low end also, high end also. So every one of you, confidently you will tell that, yes, I will get mark between 20 to 80. 80% you will have confidence interval. So because of increase in confidence, I'm trying to include interval again, 10 to 90. What is the confidence of getting your marks, statistics marks, 10 to 90 I'm asking, or your total grade, percentage of your degree, whatever. Then your confidence is increased up to 90%. 90%, although your confidence is increased, but the choice is wider. Statistically, we cannot take conclusion. Look at here, 0 to 100. What is the confidence level of getting mark from 0 to 100? Definitely any one number we will get. Even if you get 100 also, if you get 0 also, if you get 80 also, you will get one number within that interval. So you will have 100% confidence. Hope so you will be understanding. in statistics, although here I say right choice, 95% confidence interval is chosen in statistics. This is what a confidence interval. That's all. Anything, suppose I'm asking, what is the probability of today's temperature exactly 40 degrees Celsius in Trichy or exactly 30 degrees Celsius in Trichy? But what you can say confidence, it's not at all in our hand, it's in the nature's hand. Whereas instead of asking one value, if I give some interval, 32, 35, then your confidence would be lesser. If I increase much more, your confidence would be much more better. If I increase much more, so that is what. It should not become 100%, never it is possible. It is not suggested also. 100% confidence, it is not suggested to have also. So always to have 95% confidence interval in the case of, in the case of statistics. Here for the analogy perspective, story perspective, it is fine. But in the statistical world perspective, they are going for 95% confidence interval. This is the way you need to interpret, because from this moment onwards, anything which we discuss in the statistics, confidence interval is important. In the case of mean, mode, median, variance, standard deviation, variance of coefficient, these are all the discussion we had. For those all, confidence interval is not required, because those are all the measures, example for point estimation. Now only we are stepping into interval estimation. So this is a note I wanted to give. Let us go towards that. This is the best animation link in order to understand statistics. So this I will share, this document also I will share you, some material I wanted to give, then subsequently the recordings I wanted to give. Look at here, central limit theorem says normal distribution. These are all theorem, you no need to worry, don't worry of this word and all. What this says is, already I said and I have explained what is normal distribution. The data distribution should fall this shape. Visually, if you are plotting any data, if you are collecting, if it is normally distributed. For example, I will tell you one scenario. Age of your class. Forget about your faculty. The faculty member who are all attending today's session, forget those who are not students. So first year students, age, I'm calculating. Imagine all of your age would be something like that. 20, 20 or 21, whatever may be. 20, 20, 20, 20. Any couple of few students may be 21. Couple of few students may be 21. Maybe one or student, two student may be lesser age, under age. Maybe before 5 years old, you would have stepped into first standard or you would have promoted double promotion. Look at this scenario. The entire class, 30 students, you are all here. So 19, 20, 21. 21 is also very lesser, 19 is also only one, rest of all the students are fall into same age category. This is true, it is applicable. So in this scenario, this data is not at all normally distributed. It is not at all normally distributed. This is the best example to understand not normally distributed. Now let us see, what is the other example for the normally distributed? Let us say, take one apartment. especially I am living in apartment right now. In my apartment, all the age group of people I want to collect. 1 year baby is also available. 2 year baby also available. 3 years baby also available. 4 years baby also available. 5 years baby also available, etc. Then, maybe 15 years old. Really, I'm marking my apartment detail. 15 years old student is available. Not 15, maybe 12. 8th standard or something like that, students are there. 8th standard student, only one girl is there. Then, rest all, right from 25 years to Exactly, I can say 45 or 46 years. Many people are there. Then elderly people, very few. They are around 55 also people are available. 60 also available. 61 also available. Maybe 65 years old, one of the elderly person, senior citizen is available in our apartment. Look at here. Now this data is normally distributed. Look at here, gradually increasing. 1 year baby, 2 year baby, 3 year baby, 5 year baby, 12 year old child, 25, dense. So then flat curve, 25, then again increasing, 46, 55, 60, 61, 65. This is not exactly normally distributed, but more or less it is normally distributed. Now this varied nature, any phenomenon in the nature we consider, it will be normally distributed. If you consider family economy, income, family income of all your students, the entire your institution, let us consider. All your faculty also, let me consider. Then imagine your family income, I mean to say, not your income. Your father's income, mother's income, or family income, or your brother, sister's income, whatsoever. Your entire family income, I mean to say. It is very clearly we can understand from this family income of one of you maybe within 4 lakhs. Family income of, this is lowest I'm fixing, maybe less than also. Let us imagine family income of one of your friend or your faculty, maybe 3 lakhs family income, I'm telling, annual income, very low, let it be. Then one of your income definitely would be 5 lakhs, one of your income definitely would be 6 lakhs. Many of your income, middle class family, they used to say, in India, middle class family is more. So the annual income may be 10 lakh, 10.5 lakh, 10.5 lakhs. Then 10.7 lakhs, then 11 lakhs. Imagine these all, I mean to say, more number of people will fall into here. More and more. Here, more, larger. Larger number of samples will fall into this category. Beyond that, the lesser income community will be lesser. Then this will be denser. More number of people will fall in. Subsequently, higher income, maybe 15 lakhs per year, 20 lakhs per year, 50 lakhs per year, something like this. Slowly I'm increasing. Then 70 lakhs per year, the richest person of your college. So something like that, there are few people will be available. I do agree. But those people also lesser. Where exactly the people are more, if I want to represent through normal distribution, see, this tail are low distribution. This tail is low distribution. Here this peak is dense distribution. Here sparsely distributed. This is a meaning called normally distributed. Every one of your income, if I start plotting, your institution strength may be 5,000, 2,000, 1,000, 500 also. My institution strength is 5,000, including faculty, students, all together, it would go 5,000 and above also. So if I start covering everybody's salary, if I plot, most of the people will fall into this band, similar kind of people. Even in my apartment, more or less, my status people are there. Very few are lesser than income, annual income lesser than my family. There are few people well off. They are very well to do. So richest people are also available. But mostly we are into upper middle class category. So we fall into here only. Very poor also, very lesser in our apartment. Highest rich people also very lesser. Because apartment is targeted based on the income. There are apartment going 1 lakh, 1 crore also. 5 crore apartment is also available in Hyderabad. So we are in rental. But that category itself shows. So normally it will be distributed. If the data is normally distributed only, most of the packages, most of the interpretations, even t-test as per your syllabus, it will work. The very first assumption, what you are going to talk about your syllabus, t-test. student's t-test it is given, whatever it is t-test. So number one, data need to be normally distributed. This is first condition, first thumb rule. The next thumb rule, what you supposed to do is confidence interval is required. These two things you need to understand minimum, bare minimum I'm telling. Only then whatever I speak you can able to interpret. So what is normally distributed, I have given the story. What is confidence interval? If I sharply ask, okay, after completion of MSW, you need to tell me what is the probability of, not even probability, what is the confidence you are having exactly drawing the salary 35,000 per month. I want exactly 35,000. You should not get 36 also or 1 lakh also. I am not wanted. You should not get less than 1 rupee 35,000. If I put like that very sharply one point, your confidence level would be zero. If I say your salary should be 35,000 to 45,000, now slowly your confidence increases. Again, I am telling your salary, what is the confidence you are having that you will get a salary of 25,000 to 65,000. Now I am increasing the interval. So your confidence level will be more. Yes, madam, definitely I will get 25,000 to 65,000. Any one of this figure I will get as my salary. You will have more confidence. So that is called confidence interval. Now, 1 minute. The distribution sample, this is skewed, skewness. The skewness is either one end it will go and it will bias. For example, in your class, there may be 3 students, 4 students, maybe senior to you. Rest all would be 119, I said, na? This is exactly example. This fellow may be 19-year-old, rest all 20-years-old, then rest slowly reducing, that's all. Then that is skewed. No normally distributed. Class is not at all normally distributed. That is fine. Now what is normally distributed? This is how it should resemble the data. That is called normal distribution. Now, no Excel demonstration. This different material I'm using. That's all. See, I'm asking one more example I'll give. With that, I will conclude. Confidence interval. I'm giving you an assignment. Madam has to give assignment also. Tomorrow I'll be giving assignment. That is fine. Now, exactly I'm questioning you, exactly 70 hours you need to complete the given assignment, I'm telling you. What would be your confidence level? Zero. Because you may, if you are good enough in capturing or thinking or understanding or fast enough, you may have good computer, internet is stable, no rain, not trichy. So you may have power, all those things are possible. Then you may be able to complete within 30 hours also. Sometimes you may not able to complete, you may be struggling, you may recover 75 hours also. So exactly if I put condition 70 hours, no guarantee you will complete. So now if I give you interval 90 hours to 110 hours, yes, then 0 hour to 300 hour, it is 100%, that won't work in order to take decision. Now, however, the interval is increased, there is no chance for the earlier prediction. Full interval if you increase, no prediction is possible. Neither it should be too lower, nor it should be too higher. So that statistically, across the globe, people have fixed 95% confidence interval, more or less. So now look at, this is a bell-shaped curve. What is the meaning? You look at here. Here, the dense data, red color, 68% of the data should fall. In your class, 30 students, what is 60%, almost 50% is 15. 20 students should be of similar age. You should all should have similar age, 20 students. Then rest of 10 students, 5 should have lesser. Slowly you should increase, 16-year-old, 17-year-old, 18-year-old, like that. Then 5 students should be 25, 30, 35, and like that you should increase. If that kind of data is available, then only this bell-shaped curve will come. If all of you are same age, maybe one student this end, one student that end, it won't fit into normally distributed. So percentage of data falls within the interval, 68% this interval. This is called 6 sigma. First sigma, second sigma, third sigma, fourth sigma, 6 sigma, there are sigma available. That is too higher to understand. This is enough for right now to start with. Then this green, up to this green bell. So this is the interval. This interval is 95% confidence interval statistics. Then this blue color band, up to this, that width, you mean to understand that width. That up to this blue, it is 99.7. 100% they will consider this based on normal distribution. Most of the healthcare professionals and manufacturers, they will use 6 sigma. So look at in the internet, 6 sigma is a famous course, 6 sigma course. If you want to be a leader of the industry, bulb manufacturing, Philips bulb, something like that, if you want to go, you want to join any of the electronic goods, Usha fan, those kind of fans. What is the meaning is defects should become zero. The product which they are, Ford company, Ford, TVST, these are all the high cost companies. So the product is crossed together, they will sell. So then every product deficiency should become zero. By the time only they will go for 100% confidence interval, 6 sigma level. Otherwise not required. Now let us move on to the next level. Look at here. These are all few thumb rule you should be able to understand. Most of the time we will use 1 minus alpha into 100%. 90% confidence, 95% confidence, 99% confidence. Preferably, we will use this only. Fix in your mind, even anyone gives assignment, exam point of view also. Don't confuse anything. Just try 95% confidence interval. So alpha level, 0.5. Confidence, 95% confidence interval. Remaining what else is left out? Only 5%. That 5, only 5, the value 5. That 5, you need to convert it into percentage. Then 0.05. Then what is the Z value? Z value is 1.96 for the 95% confidence interval. This much sufficient. Rest all you no need to worry. Again and again it is repeating. This is called 6 sigma. Sigma 1, sigma 2, sigma 3. So this is 6 sigma value. This 98, 68, 95, 99.7 rule. This is what the rule used for in confidence interval. So that is sufficient. Now let us consider what else you are going to understand in today's class. Let us focus. Look at this picture, you need to understand. Given the mean, this is population mean. Now we are stepping into statistical part. Population mean is given, you need to use z-test. Population mean is not given, you need to use t-test. That's it. So these are all the two differences you should know. This is called population mean. See, interval estimation, point estimation, this mean, exactly this mean is point estimation. Within this interval, whether our predicted value falls or not, that is interval estimation. So what is interval estimation? What is t-test is? We will take a sample from the population, then we estimate finally based on the confidence interval. This is what we are going to discuss. This is highly related to t-test, this diagram. Next, look at here again. Variance of the sample mean. How to find out variance for the sample mean? If the population mean is given, you can use this formula. Population mean, whatever they are giving. See, this is the mean value. They will write the entire population mean is. In English, they will write R the population mu equal to, they will give like that. So whenever you will get population mean or you will get variance also, any one thing, then sigma square divided by N. Using this formula, you can find out sample mean. What is sampling? Already I said, entire world are corona affected people are sample population. Drawing 20 patients and giving new drugs. In Tamil Nadu, people are giving lot of Siddha medicine, Ayurveda medicine, they will test on only few number of patients. If it works, they will announce, yes, it is working for 25 corona patients, it is proved. Then we all need to understand whether we need to consume that medicine or not, if at all corona affected. So they will work on only sample, entire population, never ever, especially medical field, they will be considering. So pilot study also people used to do. It is like that. They will draw sample out of it, then they will work on it. What is observation? What is the statistics or real-time observation, improvement in the health condition, lung capacity? All the things they will measure. From that, they will conclude, yes, it works well for so-and-so disease. So that is called sampling. So sampling mean always will be less than the population mean. That we should also understand. Sample mean will be less than the population mean. But sample should be normally distributed. When the population is normally distributed, sample which we draw should be normally distributed. It should not have skew distribution and all. It should be normally distributed. Now look at what we are going to do. Finally, we are going to, whenever we are going for statistics, this is what we are going to calculate. We will be calculating with a point estimation, mean value, given mean value plus confidence level, 95%. It is fixed. Now in your case, don't confuse anything, 95%. Then sigma, margin of error, divided by square root of n, number of samples. In you suppose I'm taking 25 patients for drug experimentation, then the 25 is the number of samples. So this is what we are going to add, plus or minus. When we will use plus or minus is two tail, both end, how many the lower number of values, how many higher number of values, this will work out. In order to understand that, we will use this formula. So this is the ultimate result we are going to find out. Say sample mean, then this is rejected region. The colored region is rejected region. Anything which you find out, the T value should fall between these values. Only then it is accepted the null hypothesis. If it is not within this region, if it is above, then it is said as alternate hypothesis. This one slowly we will discuss, nothing to worry. Using that formula, minus if you are doing, that is called lower confidence interval. Plus you are doing, it is called upper confidence interval. That is fine. Now you will be confused. What is lower confidence interval? What is upper confidence interval? For example, I am picking roll number 7 from your class. I am planning to issue a credit card. Imagine I am the banker. I am running a bank. Or I am an agent, I want to issue a credit card to your family. So, although I have varied category of credit card, platinum, gold, so many credit cards are available, an ordinary card, although it is ordinary card, I can fix you the amount of lower limit of credit value, upper limit of credit value. By that time, I need to use these all. Based on your CIBIL score, based on your annual income, based on all your loans, whichever, all the loans are interconnected across the bank. Personal loan from one bank, jewel pledging, jewel loan from one bank, and house loan from one bank. If I am getting from different banks, all the banks are interconnected. All together, I will come to know the information. So I need to take decision. How much I need to give a credit limit? 1 lakh minimum or 50,000 minimum, 3 lakhs maximum. I am issuing the card to the roll number 7 to his or her family. Now fixing this limit is called lower confidence limit. Based on statistical measure, I need to fix the credit value for your family when I am issuing a credit card. If I fix you 3 lakhs, that is upper confidence interval. So this finding out these two values only, I need statistic support. I will have most of your information, like CIBIL score, whatever, your salary, whatever. Based on that, I need to take decision how much credit limit I need to give to you. That is what statistics guides and helps, because they don't know. They can't understand your face value. You may be a good person, may not be a good person. So I need to be safer. I'm the banker. Never I would have come to your house. I don't know about your attitude. I don't know about your family values. How can I decide? So statistics only will decide. Suppose you and me are friends. Satyabhama madam, last year also she contacted, this year also she contacted. If she asks for 5 lakhs loan, she's asking, give me 5 lakhs madam, I'll pay within 1 month. I know her attitude, I know some value I have, then I can think of giving her 5 lakhs for 1 month. With interest, without interest, that is for different story. But when I deal with unknown person, how can I trust and how can I give? Then statistics only helps or guides me to take decision. This is how all the bankers are working. Even if you go for applying a loan, housing loan you will apply. Or you go and apply farm loan, personal loan, any loan you try to apply. They will have some calculation, some statistics or some way of taking decision. You may quote for housing loan 40 lakhs. That is what you would need. But they don't give 40 lakhs. They will verify all other parameter. From that, they will fix. They will tell you are eligible for only 32 lakhs. So sorry. They will tell like that. How they are taking decision that 32 lakhs only permitted for this customer. So that is where statistics plays a role. That taking 32 lesser value, what is the upper value I can give? So that decision, they don't tell precisely 32 lakhs also. You are eligible to get between only 30 to 35 lakhs. What amount you want? They will ask. That how they conclude 30 to 35 lakhs only I'm eligible. That is where these two confidence interval, lower limit confidence interval, upper confidence limit interval. This is how they are taking decision. Not only banking, for your ease of understanding, I'm telling, so many field they apply statistics. Now, please understand this. When you can use interval estimation, of population mean is known. The moment you are given the population mean, you need to go for z-test. The moment you are given the interval estimation, unknown variance, here known variance, see, population variance is known. What is that variance? Sigma. Here, when you can use t-test is, you are not given the variance, unknown population mean or unknown variance. When the population mean or variance are not given, then you need to go for t-test. That's all. So this one thumb rule you need to understand. Now let us go one by one. When to use Z distribution, standard normal. Now T is close to 30, around 30. Number of samples are around 30, then T test. More than 30 only Z test. Next, less than 30, then you need to use again T distribution and smaller than 30. So this, when you can use one more way is, if the number of samples are lesser, then you need to use t-test. More and more samples, then statistics won't helpful for, it will not helpful for taking decision. That is where data analytics, machine learning, people are talking about recent days. Now, which test we need to use? Z-test or t-test? Now, let us see one question and exam. Through this example, we can able to understand. See, read carefully. I will also read, you will also read. Because this is a problem statement. Example of interval estimate of population mean with known variance. The moment I say known variance, what test you supposed to use? Known, the word is given, Z test. Unknown, if it is not given, T test. So I supposed to use Z test only. There is no other go. Imagine you have sampled 40 units of the latest production. Lot to measure the weight of the product. The sample mean is 10.40 LBS. Weight of the product unit LBS. If the population standard deviation is known, they are straight away they are giving population standard deviation 0.60 LBS. They themselves fix the confidence interval, 95% confidence interval. This is what problem statement. Like this only statistics problem statements will be there. With few data also they will give, without few data also they will give. So through in which we need to understand, we need to solve the problem. Let us see. Now first step, you need to list out all the parameters. Only then you can take decision. See, n is equal to 40, greater than 30, naturally z test. Next, variance is known. Population variance is 0.6 LBS, it is given. Confidence interval, 95% confidence interval. The moment 95% confidence interval, what is the alpha value? I said 0.05. Because the left out information is 5. That 5 you need to convert into percentage. When you are converting into percentage, it is 0.05. Next, what is the other parameter is given? Sample mean is given. What is the sample mean? X bar equal to 10.4 LBS. Once if these all noted down, then we can proceed with calculation. Now, you need to find out. One table is there. I will give you the table also. This all, even examination, they will give the table. So, Z score 95%, 1.96. It is fixed, 1.96. Since it is two-tail test, two-tail means both of the tail, that 5% rejected that area, lower confidence, upper confidence we discussed now, then both in two-tail. Now, what is your problem, Banu? Why you are trying to write? See, you are making fun of things. I am seriously discussing that you should learn something. Ridiculous. Then see, Z score is 1.96. You need to go for Z alpha divided by 2 because it is two tail test. Both of tail means what? Tail means what? In Tamil, it is wall. So look at the tail is down this side. So that is the reason here they will call tail. So Z alpha divided by 2 into sigma divided by square root of n. So this is the formula for calculating confidence interval. So just you need to plug in, that's all. What is X bar? You noted down 10.4. And what is Z is alpha divided by 2? 1.96. Then what is the sigma value? Sigma value 0.6. What is your n? 40. Just you need to plug in. I will roll out to the top side. Look at look at here. Sigma value. Try to map. What is your n? Look, substitute here in the formula. What is your sigma? Substitute in this formula. What is your alpha? Confidence interval right now it won't be helpful. X bar, what is your X bar? This. When the confidence interval is useful is only to take decision for this value. Already it is taken decision. 95 confidence interval, what is the Z score associated is 1.96. So that is what here it is substituted. When it is substituted, after the simplification, you will get this. If you do summation of these two, this. If you do subtraction of these two, this. Summation of these two, this. You will get this. This is the range. Finally, what is the conclusion you need to take for this given problem statement is, you will be picking the product of that particular company. What is the weight of that product? See, my mobile is there. I am having my mobile. What is the weight of this product? So the product weight will fall into these two intervals. 10.21 LBS minus 10.59 LBS. Why? See, 10.4 is original. Slowly will vary, you know, depending upon the metal, depending upon the welding, depending upon what the term. All other solid ring, this all, it will vary. Although mobile is manufactured by the same company, 2-3 mobiles, it will not become same weight. So in order, how it varies, that vary. Look at here, very, very small confidence interval. 10.4 plus or minus 0.186. 1 gram only may vary. So 10.21, 10.58. So they need to justify to the standards also. They will be coming for auditing inspection. So they will be getting benchmark standard, ISO standard something. Then they need to support the weight of the product also. For that, they will be doing this all calculation statistics. First, what they will do is they will calculate population. Entire, all the manufactured product, they will be taking 40 units. For that alone, this entire product, what the whatsoever they have manufactured, for that the standard deviation is 0.6. That also they have. Then they are asking, what is a confidence interval of having the product which you are picking randomly falling into the weight, which range of weight it will fall. So they are giving 95% confidence interval you can use. When this 95% confidence interval is useful? In order to find out the alpha value, significance level. Why we are using that significance level is, that significance level only will decide either T value or Z value. Anything, it is decided. So this is the prime objective of doing statistics. It's more or less same like only it will be for t-test. Let us see that also. Now we are moving to t-test. Why we are moving to t-test is, look at the given samples are only five adult. What they are doing is they are calculating average IQ, brain capacity, their thinking capacity, intelligent capacity of the adult population is 100. They may be taking entire apartment adult, they may be measuring IQ level. So 100 people they are doing, adult population. Now look at, researcher believes that average IQ of adult is lower. We used to tell, no, elderly people, when you become, your age becomes more and more, you behave very silly, like that we will be angry time, we will be telling, no? Like that somebody is telling. So they want to prove that, they want to evidently statistically prove really the person telling is right or not. So what they are doing in their family, they are collecting their age, sorry, IQ level of five elderly people. Your grandmother of mother's side, father's side, grandmother, grandfathers. Imagine you are taking some members. Then you are going for calculating standard deviation. You need to prove whether the IQ level of adult population, the overall population is 100, your family population is worse than that, or they are same. You want to prove. See, look at, by looking at this data itself, we can say these three data are near zero. These two only more or less not near zero. Naturally, your entire family members IQ level, it will declare that more or less equal to population IQ level only. By looking at the data itself, we can discuss, we can take decision. But how statistics going to tell? That is the beauty you are going to enjoy. So that first we need to write hypothesis. So these are all first step. If I touch upon hypothesis, it would take much more hour. I don't know when it will be completed. What is hypothesis? First, the problem statement, claim, we need to formulate before going for statistics. What here we are trying to tell is, your family members, let us imagine, their IQ level. Your family member, adult means anyone, grown up, even I am adult, you are also adult. Those who are crossed teenage, you all are adult. None of you are teenage. Your UG time, you would have been in teenage. After UG, you all are into, adulthood age. So look at here. I'm telling hypothesis, null hypothesis. Null hypothesis, never ever it will give encouragement or discouragement. It will tell it is equal, no big difference. So this your family member, imagine these five are your family member. Your family member IQ is equal to population IQ. Next, alternate hypothesis, what is telling? Your claim is you need to prove. whether their IQ is equal or less, greater and not a botheration. Now what is the problem is mu less than 100. I am trying to tell your family member IQ is not at all equal to population IQ. Your family IQ level is lesser. I am trying to tell, claim. But let us see how the statistics is. What is null hypothesis is no change. Your family IQ and the population IQ, there is no change. Always this is the way you need to formulate hypothesis, guys. Formulating hypothesis, people even PhD level, they will be confused. Understand, whenever you are writing null hypothesis, it will tell there is no big change. Always it will tell there is no, there is no, there is no, that word you should remember. There is no difference, that word. I will write here itself in English so that you will understand. 1 minute. This is general way I am telling. There is no difference. This is what always null hypothesis will tell. It may be lower, your family IQ may be higher IQ or lower IQ. That is different scenario. What null hypothesis will tell? Anything it may be, not only your IQ question, anything, it will tell no difference, no need of action, no need of no, 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 it will tell. It will discourage. What is your alternate hypothesis is? Always it will encourage. That's all. Now what is this? Let us see. Whenever you want to do hypothesis testing, you need to state null hypothesis, alternate hypothesis. You need to choose level of significance. Since you may feel confused, I fixed that always it is think in your brain 95%. Until otherwise you feel requirement of statistics, you just think that 95% confidence interval. Next thing, you need to find out the critical value. What is the critical value? See, I was finding out 1.96, no? 6. Similarly, you need to find out T value at 95% confidence interval. That is called critical value. Then you need to find the test statistics, whether T test or Z. Here, T test only. Because that sample is 30, population variance is not given. Population standard deviation is also not given. So that I need to take decision. So find the t-test, then draw the conclusion. These are all the 5 thumb rule or mantra for t-test anyone would do in the world. Now let us move on solving the problem. How the confidence interval I am using, let us see. See, look at here. I'm going to use 0.5 confidence interval, alpha level. Then degrees of freedom. What is degrees of freedom? Even ANOVA test, it is required. I will tell you right now, this is what we need to use for the T value. This is ready-made table. Like this, tables are given for C test or T test. So 2.132 is called the value I need to know down for solving this problem. Let us see what is degrees of freedom. Degrees of freedom means, look at here, how many family members I have considered from your family. I have considered 5. When I consider 5 adult, minus 1 I need to use. Degrees of freedom, statistical world, they use DF. It should be N minus 1. Now, number of family members I have considered for this IQ test from your family is 5 members. So what would be your degrees of freedom? 5 minus 1, 4. So 4 is your degrees of freedom. These are all the stuff we need to remember all the time. So this is the table given. Look at here. First, I have fixed the confidence interval. What is my first? Yeah. Null hypothesis, alternate hypothesis. Yes, I have said your family IQ level is not at all different from the population IQ level. That is a claim H0. What is H1? Your family IQ level is lesser than all other people. Your family, none of you, have more IQ. Like that I am trying to tell. Let us see statistical. Don't be angry. Statistically, it will conclude that your family members are high IQ. That is the reason I am considering your family member. So H1 is what? Your family member doesn't possess good IQ. H0 is what? Your family member is having high IQ or whatever, the IQ of other people. Now let us see. What is the first step? Yeah, I have written. You agree? No? Just now I have written. First hypothesis, I have written that null hypothesis, your family member also possess the same IQ level of population, all other members of your community or your city. That is the meaning null hypothesis. What is alternate hypothesis? I'm trying to claim that your family members doesn't possess a good IQ level or compared to the population, your living area people, your family IQ level is less. That is what I have proposed. That is over. Choose the level of significance, alpha. What is the alpha value I have chosen? 0.05. Why? Because the confidence level, this is level of significance. What is my confidence level which I have chosen? 95%. So because of 95%, what is the level of significance? 0.05. What is the critical value? 2.13. I don't forget beyond that, something like that from the table. So find the critical value. These three steps I'm done. What is the step I am pending? Finding the statistics test and drawing the conclusion. Only these two steps are pending. Now let us go to that discussion. See, this is the formula. What is the formula? Is x, that x bar minus mu s variance divided by square root of n. We need to plot all the points which is given. So first we need to note down all the points which are all given in the problem statement. Look at average IQ is 100, standard deviation is 15.81. So these are all the 2 points it is given. Let us go here. We need to plug in 100, that is given. So next, average, it is given, no? Mu, mean, average are same, 100. Next, 15.81. What is that 15.81? So this is a standard deviation. If I calculate the mean, x bar of these all, I would be getting 89. This 89 is not that one. You can even calculate. If you calculate mean of all your family members IQ level, then you will be ending up with 89. So that 89 only plugged into this formula. 89 minus 100 divided by 15.85. What is n? See, look at square root of n formula. What is n? 5. 5 members from your family I have taken for analysis. What is the value it is producing? T-test value. This is a formula for t-test. It is producing minus 1.56. Minus 1.56, where it lies, look at here. This is 0.5 mean value. This is here also 0.5. This minus 1.56 is falling within this range, within this interval. See, finally, this is a 95% confidence interval I'm fixing. So this 95% confidence interval within this range, if it falls, no, within this range, the value is falling within this range, so that I am concluding your family members possess good IQ value like other families in your community or in your country or in your city, anything. I'm compare. How you compare? Look at Ram's mother. Look at Raja's mother. She is so clever. You are not clever. Like that only we criticize, no? So like that. Now the conclusion part. Fifth step. Conclusion. What we need to take is the obtained t-value fits within the confidence interval. Hence, the sample adults also possess the same IQ level of the population. That's all. This is how you need to write or conclude your statistical report. So what is the interpretation? What is the value you have obtained? Why you are concluding like that? You need to write. So this is what one problem we can see. We need to, if you are okay, I will walk through one more problem. This is of Z test. Because population variance is given, then you need to go for Z test. Otherwise, you need to go for T test. Look at here, confidence interval. 95.5 Z test value. For the T, I have shown now, similarly, T test value. Z test. If you look at Z test, no degrees of freedom. If you look at T test, degrees of freedom, DF is available. So because of that only, number of samples are less than 30 or less than or equal to 30, they emphasize you to use t-test. Because for this degrees of freedom, how many you can give? Up to 30 it is possible. Beyond 30 you can't give table generated stuff. That is the reason they are going for c-test. So more or less z-test, t-test would be same. Only the point is you may need to interpret or you may need to change the value, T value, Z value, that's all. So with that note, let us, let me go through. See, nothing more. Call hypothesis testing. What is hypothesis testing? Only it is written. Yeah, again, one sample t-test. There are several concepts I may need to tell. See, P value is less than alpha, you need to reject H naught. P value is greater than alpha, you need to accept H naught. So these are all those things. Now I will tell you a thumb rule like information. With that, see, sample one, whenever you are given to compare sample one, your class and the second year MSW, I wanted to compare your class performance with the second year MSW performance, especially in the statistics subject, one subject only. Then I need to go for two sample test. One sample means only your class. I need to have the population information I should have. I need to compare whether with respect to that you are performing good or worst. So that I need to take decision, then one sample. So now two sample, there is no significant difference between drug A and drug B. There is a significant difference between drug A and drug B. These are all the way you can do. Only one more point is the same null hypothesis, confidence interval, decision rule, t-test, decision, whatsoever, wherever you study, the same you will get. Another point what I want to tell you is when to use one tail test, when to use two tail test. With that note, statistics, let me complete today and I will go to some other topic. Now look at here, two tail or one tail. When you supposed to use two tail, sorry, one tail. Whenever in the problem, understand, whenever in the problem, the word is given less than or greater than, then you need to use one tail. See, look at greater than means in that distribution, you will be into one end now. See, this is less than zone. This is greater than zone. I am giving what is the probability that your class performance is above 85-80%, I'm asking, then it is greater than problem. What is the probability or what is the conclusion that your class is performing worse or less than 80%, I'm telling. I need to prove statistically. For that, if I am putting less than or greater than, then any kind of this relationship comes, that is called one tail. Then when you need to use two tail, whenever the problem is given with the word, not in mathematical, in English also, whenever equal to, not equal to are given, then you must use two tail. That's all. So finally, I will conclude once again. One tail when you need to use. When to use. This is your question. One tail when you need to use is whenever problem has the keywords or less than or greater than, this kind of words are there, analysis, they are asking you to analyze, asking you to take decision. Look at that IQ level, that is one tail test. because your family or members are having less than the population mean IQ. That is a claim given. So that is one tail test. That is the reason in the graph, one tail, one end only that rejection region was there. Other than that, anything you have, that all accepted. Next, two tail. When to use two tail? When to use two tail? This is your question. So the moment you read the problem statement, within the problem statement, equal to or not equal to, this kind of stuff, the moment it is given, you need to prefer two tail test. So these are all the clue you may need to understand. With that you can solve any problem. Now I'll walk through the calculator. Yesterday I have given introduced on calculator, no? That calculator I will introduce. Then we move on to the other stuff of discussion. See, this is what t-test calculator. Two independent means, two dependent means. Then single sample, it is given. Look at here, single sample. Imagine your college students, entire college performance would be 80. Normally, no one will get more than 80. More or less, my students used to get 80, around 80. That is a claim they are telling in your college. Then what I supposed to do? Then sample. First year students are coming. I'm just plugging their mark. All the mark entry, because it is t-test is less than 30, no? So you can enter these values. You can keep on entering. It will accept 30 values, not more than that. So it won't accept more than that. See, look at here. Confidence interval, 99%, 90%, 95%. You are given the freedom to choose. I said blindly all the time, try to use 95 across the globe, it is given. So this, next, whether one tail or two tail. When, how I can say, if your class, I am claiming that MSW is not appreciating, they will perform less than. Then statistically I need to prove, that is fine. These are all your marks, your class marks. Let us imagine these are all your marks. I have given you full marks. So much marks I had given. So your class mark. Now I am going for one tail test. Click this calculate. It takes some time. Now calculation. It is giving the value 5.01567. One tail test, I am telling. So this T value becomes positive. So this shows that your class is result significant. P is less than 0. So these are all the interpretation you need to take and consider. Finally, it concludes that your class performance is better than or is also equally comparable with your set benchmark of your class, your institution. Your institution, higher authority says that you are having 80%. Your institution, normally they used to get 80% mark. Any student comes to my college, they used to get 80% mark, they are claiming. I need to verify whether your class, looking at this data itself, I can understand. Look at here, 80, 90, more or less, the worst mark itself I have given 77. Very worst mark itself I had given 77. The same calculator you can play. How you can play? Then try all the mark, worst mark. 20, 30, 40, 50, like that you try. And fix this confidence interval, fix one tail, calculate, understand the t value and this inferences, how it gives. When I am giving good marks to all the students and comparing, when I am giving very worst marks to all the students, when I am comparing, you can learn quickly using this link, this particular link. Only the data, just the same example you take. Your mark, I will share this link in the chat window. Make a note. Tomorrow I will ask a question. So what is the 1 minute, it is a problem. I have shared. You can note down. Yeah, use this and play around the t-test which I have discussed today. So the same, imagine your college principal is telling that 80% my students are always average, my college performance is 80. So that 80, then imagine all the students are worst performer. I try to give 40 mark, 30 mark, 25 mark, 50 mark, maybe 1 or 2 marks you can give nearby 70, rest all reduce less than 60 and understand how it gives a t value. This is simple calculator. Internally, what is happening only I have explained how it is interpreting, what is the value it is substituting, what are all those stuff happening, the theoretical discussion. But directly if you do calculator, you may not able to interpret how it works. That is the reason we walked through the calculator. More or less today we are concluded student t-test. The left out concepts are ANOVA and chi-square. That two tests we are going to discuss tomorrow. Then in addition to that, t-test and z-test, these all in detail I discussed already in my YouTube channel. I'll give that link also, you can watch. That is for M-Tech students class which I have handled. So that also you can watch for better idea. Now for the English test, what are all the stuff we can do? We can do with reverso spell check. You put in the internet spell checker, there are several are available which I use only, I am just using, I am showing. So reverso spell check, main the best thing is Google Doc. That is more than enough. Anything which you do it in the Google Doc, automatically it shows the way of correction. See, look at here, there are document. Even now also I am working, I'm preparing material. Most of the time I supposed to prepare the material without plagiarism. I should not copy paste from the internet as such, because anything which you author know, if I am authoring a book, it should not have more plagiarism. The publishers will not accept because they will get into copyright issues conflict. So imagine this is the book. So always I work within this Google Doc. It has given a couple of bugs, issues, comma, this all it had given. So this all I have written by my own words from the above illustrations, this all. When I write from my first M characters, whenever I am writing my own way, I tend to commit a grammatical mistake. So by the time only it is helpful. So M. So how the Google Doc is helpful? Imagine. Here automatically it suggests and it recommends the punctuations, all the stuff it is recommending. Hope so you can able to understand what the paraphrasing tool I am trying to mention. Now instead, how it is going to help me? Let me copy paste some paragraph. Look at here, I am copy pasting this paragraph here to, this is central alignment, okay, sorry. Just federal alignment I should use. Now I am coming back to reverso. I need to paste here. Then you need to fix English. Then after that, see, it is permitting 450 characters, not more than that. Piece of information only you can put. Now check. Normally it won't give error. I'm very sure. Then whether you are working for US English or UK English, you can log in with Gmail or your institution account. That will have much more feature. Now I need to click check. See, the set of the closest points it is recommending. Use to find this set of the closest points. Again, here the has come, so that only I have avoided. But it is giving the closest point. I can go here, set the set of, find the set of the closest point. This is what it is recommending. The same I am trying here also. Google Doc also not giving any error. So it is better. It is understood that whatever reverso had given, it is better. Sometimes it is possible to translate. It allows only foreign languages, not Indian language. See, one language to another language. So this is how I work for fixing the bugs. Hope so, guys, you would have got to know how Reverso is working, how Google Doc is working. The piece of information I have taken from here to here, already I thought that this is working too good. Assuming that only, I went to that particular point. I'll copy this piece of information to here. Spell check. Now, what I supposed to do is, directly I should not go. I need to go here, check again, edit. I need to click edit. Oh, no, close. This close button is for clearing. After clearing, I need to paste rest of information. It is telling that exceeded. I have exceeded. Yeah, now it has come within the limit. That is the only drawback. So I'm checking. No mistakes. Look at here. Earlier it had given mistake. Now it is telling no mistake. So that's it. So you take decision which tool you can use. These two I'm introducing. Next I will introduce a couple of tools. But these two only I appreciate. Whatever I'm introducing for the sake of SpinBot. SpinBot I'm using. Click here, SpinBot. Recommended software tools. You can explore this lot of stuff available. Free version only I'm talking. So free version, what it will do, I will show you. Yeah, I will just here I am going to enter the Holy Cross students are always best performer. I'm just writing best performer. Now I need to click this captcha. I'm not a robot. When you see, it allows 10,000 character. I can't sit and write essay for you now. So that I have written only one sentence about you. What is all about this tool? I will explain later. What is this? My monitor dot. One dot is there. Yeah, it is dirt on my monitor. Okay, go. Click go. What it will do is recommendation. The Sacred Cross understudies are in every case better entertainer. It will give some recommendation. It is absolutely ridiculous. Always best performer in academics. Let me this holy, it is changing to sacred. So let it be. My students are always best performer in academics. So I need to click the capture. So it will give some recommendation, suggestion. See, my understudies students, it is taking into understudies. Instead of students, it is telling understudies. Are in every case best entertainer in scholastics. Sometimes it is not coming perfectly. Sometimes it works. That is the reason I said that I don't prefer. What is the meaning is plagiarism free rating. Whenever we are in the position to copy paste and avoid something, no, by the time we can use. Now let me copy the technical stuff, how it recommends, let us say. I'm copying, sometimes appreciating, sometimes I hate this too. So I have copied my technical articulations. Go. I'm giving go. From the above outlines, for every cycle, it moves an example, one situation to you. Totally, it is changed the context itself. In the event that a confounding Paris experience, sometimes it is giving as some sentences, sometimes it is giving vocabulary. So choice is yours. I'm just introducing this tool. These all working based on artificial intelligence. How the logic, how powerful they are doing, depending upon that only it will behave. So you and me cannot do anything. So in the event that a confounding Paris experience, something like that is giving, that's all. So this is called SpinBot. The name of the tool is SpinBot. So what you guys need to do know, now as early as possible, I will give the materials. You need to, I mean, it's a video, recorded video. You need to compile the material. Instead of me giving, you should compile the material. That is the way the learning will happen. Now this is over. One more tool I will try to include to you, introduce to you. Now, another tool, google.com. Plenty are available, which are all I am referring only, I'm trying to use. Ref and write. Ref and write. Not and, in, ref and write. So academic phrase bank or paraphrasing techniques. So use this, click. See how to introduce, they will give some suggestions. So we can make use of this English. Literature review. Yeah, write something, how to introduce, importance of topic. It will suggest, see, if you have something, you can write here and it will give some recommendation. If you paraphrase, it will give. Get writing ideas, like a spin bot only. Otherwise, this is a topic of pivotal importance. You can start like this. There has been an increased recognition. This has become an issue of great importance recently due to this technique has opened up new challenges. So these are all the way. Next, if you want to talk about statistics, data analysis, data collection and processing, data source. If you are interested to talk about data, write about data, you need to click. Yeah. An important component of the research is data collection and analysis. To start a sentence for the writing, this is an excellent method for collecting data for use in the research. Although useful for generating lots of data, so these are all the way sentences depending upon your context. See, look at this left hand side. This is called phrase bank. Then writing ideas, it gives some writing ideas. Even for researchers, it will be useful. For this are all free version. Licensed version, it has much more technique. Explain or describe. See, if you want to explain about the concept, framework, process, properties and the characteristics, idea, you can get to know the way of the idea was first introduced by. The idea behind this model is, or this analysis is, idea has led to the development of several commercial systems, something like this. So this is a way you can pick few sentences if you wish. So the few tools for writing related, I will introduce, I said. So that today we have seen Reverso Spell Check, Google Doc, SpinBot. SpinBot I'll put in the last rank, Ref and Write. So these are all the four tools I use for my writing or my verification, paraphrasing something. There are plenty are available. You can explore internet, Google. Paraphrasing tools. You need to write paraphrasing tools. See, this is the word, paraphrase, paraphrasing tools. So this is what you need to use. Hope so, you may be getting what I'm trying to tell. So next, let me put one sentence for the paraphrase by this tool, how it is telling. Let us see. Here only we have verified that check. I'm pasting here paraphrase. It's not giving anything. No, only for licensed version, I guess. No, it is not giving, only for the licensed version. So only we can refer this all, writing ideas we can refer, that's all. Not giving. Yeah, with that note, today I'm concluding.